In this Dungeon Master's Guide, I'll be going through The Legend of Spelljammer by Jeff Grubb. This has got to be one of the craziest ships ever to grace the already bizarre world of Spelljammer. I was meeting with several archaeologists of a very important client at Cartania's canteen when one of them mentioned the rumors of the whereabouts of Spelljammer, the Queen of Wildspace. I, like many in my line of work, have lusted over this relic. It has long been considered destroyed. Apparently a disturbance in the planar fabric caused by the destruction of Omnispace allows Spelljammer to return to the material plane. The rumors is the ship is sentient and serves a dark power and is a vessel for the gods, but the ship has been known to save stranded crew. What we do know is that the ship is mammoth in size, 1/3 of a mile from stern to stern. This is the largest known object to be able to spelljam. An ancient tune I read on Lionheart's library states the ship is sentient and looks like the cross between a manta ray and a scorpion. The elves believe the thoughts drive the ship. It does not require a captain or a crew to function. It takes care of its own maneuvering and power through servitude constructs called shivics. Shivics are constructed helpers of the Spelljammer. They act as its eyes and ears and hands of delicate work. They're omnipresent and generally non-violent. They appear in numbers of forms. Most of them parallel the basic body designs of sentient races in known space, either a humanoid, centaur, beholder, nyogi, serpentine. Shivics are made of the same material skin of the Spelljammer. They have a leathery, well-worn look. They do not communicate to other inhabitants and merely just perform their task. They're solid without a detectable body or organs except at its center. There are supposedly 5,000 living individuals on this ship. They have been known to fight among themselves. They are of all races of wild space. They are trapped here by magical scents and fragrances let out by the ship and charm people in its air bubble every 12 hours. If charmed, the person will not harm the ship or leave it. The most surprising aspect is her speed, which is faster than most ships, 10 times smaller. It lacks a command center, but does have a command bridge at the forward quarters, but is waiting for a chosen individual or captain. The outer hull is 50% magic resistance and made of a leathery material. It is rumored that it has 30 catapults, 40 ballistas, and various other smaller catapults and ballistas, and also has a tail sting. At the end of the tail is a sphere of annihilation. It follows its targets. This can only be done when there is a captain on board. I've heard a book written long ago stating that the ship can produce smaller versions of itself, like offspring. The ship mates with the captain, but not physically. It is merely his presence that provides the ship with the ability to produce. The captain creates small gardens of spelljammers during this time. It usually lasts 18 weeks. The seeds it produces will become new ultimate helms, about 100 at a time during a captaincy. The ultimate helms are kernels of magical energy at the start and find their way to other realms where they release a new spelljammer. They strike inanimate objects and create a new helm. The ship is also a city and has all sorts of species, from illithid goblins to dwarves and elves. There is even an arcane, but he has gone insane because of the ship rejected him. From the tomb I read on Lionheart, the Elven Armada have a tower there to and welcome elven ships that enter. There is much more, but it gets convoluted with rumors. Whatever the truth is, I would do almost anything to see this ship in real life. So let's go over some of the locations of Spelljammer. There are 42 distinct sections of Spelljammer, with many races getting their own lair or tower. There is a library tower where a wizard has locked himself in. No one enters, but rumors swirl that the wizard is dead. The Illithid Tower is run by Trebek. There are around 70 mind flayers. They receive tithes by the goblins. Politics stop them from openly hunting for food. The Beholder ruins that house a dozen beholders are led by an extremely old tyrant, Grey Eye. They were nearly wiped out by a disease called blind rot. Rumors have it that it was created by the Illithid or the Nyogi. The Beholders are a mere fraction of the force that they were once. The Nyogi Tower is led by Master Ko, but the real leader is the great old master who demands fresh meat. They and the beholders have been at war for some time now. The Dark Tower is an ominous building that has a nasty reputation. Shiviks kill all trespassers. As soon as someone enters, black smoke rises from the chimney. It is rumors that they are killed and burned, but no one has lived to tell the tale. It is actually the ship's brig where the ship puts its old captains. They are well taken care of and live luxuriously, but are never allowed to leave. The walls cannot even be teleported. There are tunnels that twist and wind underneath the surface of the ship called warrens. They are used by the Shiviks to do repairs, but around 200 undead make the warrens their home. They are led by the Fool, a former captain that became a master lich. What to do with this weird sentient floating city? There is a lot to explore in Spelljammer the ship that lies just underneath the surface. Maybe have your party get stranded and picked up by the ship. It has its eye on a potential new captain. You can deal with the underbelly of the ship where you have a Lithids, Yogi, and like old beholders there, all in a very tight space, and it doesn't always have to be one fight after another. There's a lot of political intrigue that you can introduce between all these different factions. Then you can use the ship as a quest giver because the ship is sentient. So maybe this is a central hub. You can have them going from one planet to another for a quest that they need to do during competition with other adventuring groups for role as the captain. There are endless ways you can use this in your adventures, and I hope you do, because Spelljammer is weird and wacky, and there is nothing more weird and wacky than this ship. If you enjoyed this episode and want some more videos, please hit that thumbs up and like and subscribe. Thank you so much.